Get your decade ahead horoscope now at NadiyaShah.com. Hello, fabulous Leo. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of July 2019, looking at life and love. I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out right now. And boy, is it special. What makes it special is the eclipses. We are going to enter eclipse season in the early days of this month. It's right around the 3rd, give or take a day on either side, depending on where you are on the planet. And this eclipse is going to be one that is happening in the sign just before yours. This is powerful karmic closures that then allow a sense of beginning. It is an inner renewal, a cleansing on a level of psyche and soul and spirit. And eclipses in and of themselves can deliver their news by surprise, okay? With this eclipse though, it is standing across the sky from Saturn, but also speaking in supreme harmony with Neptune. Now that Neptunian connection, I'm very encouraged by. It is hopeful, it is inspiring, it is one where things are changing and you feel as if there's a certain magical momentum with another energy taking over. And with this eclipse happening in a part of the sky that is also connected to good karma, well, this can be some very nice karma finding you now. But that connection with Saturn is a little bit different. It can be a sense of external pressure. Now, for a small percentage of you out there, this can be a time when very likely workplace related, it's almost as if you learn of something, like a secret is revealed that you didn't know before. And this lends itself to a sense of change. But that beautiful connection with Neptune tells me that what is revealed related to a work-related situation, workplace-related situation, you're very quickly able to translate it and move yourself in a direction of change and renewal, but also wealth as well. There's a faith in yourself, an understanding of the resources that are available to you, and they may feel as if they just open up, encouraging you to actually make some truly notable moves that help you to connect with the wealth within, but practical wealth also. For some, this is going to be workplace related, as I said, whether it's relationships with clients, customers, coworkers, immediate supervisors. For others, this is going to be related more to your daily habits, the things that you do repeatedly. With Saturn standing across the sky, it does speak to pressure and a sense that perhaps you realize or you come to have an epiphany that some way in which you are living your life isn't working for you anymore, that you're ready to change. And this is the kind of energy that can be like just in an instant going cold turkey, changing your habits profoundly, immediately. Now, this is further affirmed by the lunar eclipse that takes place in the middle of the month. Right around the 18th is when we're going to have that lunar eclipse. Now, this is happening in a part of the sky that has to do with this day-to-day life area where Saturn is now. And in fact, this eclipse is happening close in the sky with Saturn. But the South Node is there. Pluto is there as well. And this configuration is speaking in harmony with Neptune. But it's not as strong a supremely harmonious connection, but it is a blessing. And so what this says is this real conviction, this deep understanding of where it is that you are ready to change the way in which you live your life is going to find you. Lunar eclipses are different, whereas solar eclipses are about the new and the next. It's a new moon solar eclipse, after all. A lunar eclipse is about closures, karmic closures. And I see that as a theme throughout this month for you. Yes, there's a solar eclipse, but it's happening in a part of the sky that has to do with karmic closure. The lunar eclipse not only inherently represents closure, but we've got these powerful planets happening right there, hand in hand, Saturn and Pluto, which are planets that represent a sense of realizing what has got to go, what has served its purpose. And that can be a position of power. It is going to require your action, But with a little bit of action, a little bit of faith, it can go such a long way towards solidifying the changes that are trying to take root now. So whether this is to experience better health, whether it is to experience a better sense of overall well-being, a sense of mental health, a more positive state of mental health, whether it is to just be more effective as you move through your days, all of this, the truth of this, and how you are ready to change can come to the forefront for you now. But it is in a way whose time has come, and I think that this can be dramatic, particularly for some people out there, where it can really be that habits you've held for years or decades leave you in an instant. And it may very well be epiphany energy that facilitates that. Watch the solar eclipse first, because that is going to be notable as well, but the lunar eclipse really ensures that those changes become that much more clear. Where it comes to matters of love, it is going to be as you start the month that Mars enters your sign. It is at the end of the month, about 4 weeks in, that Venus will enter your sign. Now, this to me is incredibly encouraging. Mars makes you bold, makes you brave, and it makes a person motivated to connect with another. But it is that Venus that allows you to attract, that allows you to bring love towards you. Now, next month is going to be a really big month for you where it comes to matters of love, and for you as well. You know, for this month, there's so much clearing, so much cleansing, but next month is all about beginnings. We're going to have a Venus in your sign for most of the month. We are going to have a new moon in your sign to start next month. And we are going to have a full moon in your opposite sign. So there's a lot to look forward to. That is the time when you are going to find yourself truly immersed in an understanding of self and partnership in a whole new way, which is very exciting. But at least for this month, yeah, some of that new energy is there as well, thanks to Mars. And for much of this month, that is going to be the dominant energy. If you're open to meeting someone new, there is a boldness with you now, a bravery with you now, and a certain determination to go out there and connect. And that can have you taking chances that can be well rewarded. But remember, we're also in a Mercury retrograde season. Part of that Mercury retrograde is going to be in your sign as well. And so what that says is that just when you think you know what you want, maybe not. And that really is okay. It is part of the learning and part of the journey. For those of you who are just starting to date someone, well, Mars here can represent an increase in intimacy, certainly a desire to be more connected to this person. And if you are someone who is in an established bond, just be careful. Sometimes this energy can make one frustrated with our partners. However, once we get late into the month and that Venusian energy enters the picture, it just feels as if you are celebrating the love that the two of you share that much more. What I love about this month for you, well, look, there is a lot here. I could say the eclipses, because that really is the big news this month. It is notable. It is one of these peak moments as part of a very important 2019. But I'm actually going to say that as we navigate later and later into the month for you, you are going to sense that you are on the verge of a bold and bright new beginning. You are going to feel that a brand new chapter is right around the corner. This month lays the ground. This month prepares you well. It clears space so that you truly can have a sense of your own personal new year that you start feeling as we move to the very end of this month, certainly, but is really just right around the corner. A new you, a new understanding, a new clarity of self. It may not be the time to make big, major decisions other than what's gotta go, but know that a part of letting go means that there is so much more and so much better you have to look forward to in life. Well, thank you so much for watching. You can get a video like this every week by logging on to nadiyashah.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded, exclusive videoscopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy.